Born and reared in Milford, Jim McCormick naturally followed the family line and completed his training as a pharmacist in 1966. Pharmacy had been in the McCormicks for three generations, and today his son Jared runs McGee's Pharmacy in Letterkenny, while his nephew Mark runs the McCormick Pharmacy in Milford. One of the biggest influencers in Jim's life was Val Johnson, his uncle. Val took over the running of the family and the business after Jim's father died when he was just 8 years old. Jim had two brothers, and Val took over the role of father figure. It was Val that was also responsible for instilling the business ethos into a young Jim, who worked alongside his uncle in the pharmacy business from he was 12 years old. Jim went to Dublin to study pharmacy, and it was during this time that he met his wife Fionnuala, a native of Boyle in County Roscommon, who worked in Ulster Bank. They married in 1966, the same year Jim returned to Donegal to pursue his career. So, working back in his native town of Milford, he then ventured to the big lights of Letterkenny to set up his own pharmacy.
Well, Letterkenny is an awful lot busier than Milford, but at the same time, you know, I was in pharmacy from I was 12 years of age. Started off washing bottles and working in the stores and what have you, you know, really, really interested in this. But how I got here was quite a by accident, because I was more or less waiting to go home and run the family business. When I was working for Mrs. Quinn, who owned McGee's. McGee's was founded, by the way, in 1928 by the late Leo McGee, and he sold it in 12 years later to Mrs. Quinn. And in 1966, I was manager of her pharmacy in Lifford, and she came to me and said, "Look, would you like to buy McGee's pharmacy in Letterkenny?" And I said, "No thanks, I don't have any money." And she said, "Well, don't worry about the money." She says, "We'll sort that out." And that's how I got into McGee's.
Jim McCormick is a committed family man who loves nothing more than spending time with his three sons and his eight grandchildren. Owen and Audrey have two sons, Colm and David. Jared and Anne-Marie have five daughters, Laura, Aoife, Niamh, and twins Rachel and Amy, while Brian and Lisa have one daughter, Kira. His wife Fionnuala has been the backbone of everything he has undertaken in his life.
My wife would be my main mentor, you know. She's number one. Very valuable person, very valuable lady. You know, really and truly, she would have to take a lot of the credit for the success of our business, to be honest, you know.
McGee's pharmacy has changed dramatically in the last few years, particularly with the computerisation of his business. But he is adamant that the business will move forward and respond to all changes as they have done so over the past 41 years.
Business does change, and you need young blood. And these people see things different than me. And if you look at our pharmacy today, it's totally modernised. It's completely different than it was 5 years ago. You know, things have changed, you know. Things have changed, and it takes a younger generation to drive it forward. But we will drive it forward without any doubt, you know.
One of Jim McCormick's other passions is tidy towns. It all started back when a 1975 RTE documentary about Letterkenny sparked local controversy when the programme depicted a somewhat negative view of the town.
RTE came and shot a one-hour film on the town, and he interviewed the management of Courtauld's, the late Ken Wall, and asked him about his problems coming to Letterkenny. And he pointed out that you had to bring in 30 senior management from England to the town, and he was having difficulty there because, number one, the town was very untidy. There was no parks in the town, bad footpaths, bad roads, very untidy, no leisure facilities, very little sports facilities, and schools weren't up to scratch. So it really was a hard-hitting, very insulting programme for the town, and it annoyed me and it annoyed a lot of other people.
In the early 1980s, the Tidy Towns Committee broke down, but when Jim took over as president of Letterkenny Chamber of Commerce and Industry in 1986, it marked the revival of the Tidy Towns agenda.
when I was forming the committee, I asked Dennis Doyle, who was the local tourist man, who was a qualified Tidytown judge for some years. And when I asked him, would he reform the new Tidytowns committee, he said, no, he says, I can't. He says, I'm a Tidytown judge. He says, but why don't you do it? And I said, well, you know, I don't really know how to do it. And he said, well, look, you do it and I'll help. And that's more or less the way it is today. The problem was that the town kept doubling in size. We had the town in fairly good nick by 1996 when the Tidytown adjudicator said major honours is not far away. But it was a long bit away because the town kept developing and, you know, kept getting bigger and bigger.
In September of this year, Jim, along with the Tidytowns committee, travelled to Dublin to the National Tidytowns Finals.
The tidiest large urban centre for 2007 is Letterkenny.
We didn't expect to win because to win, you must win the regional award and you must win the county award, and we were 5 points behind in the county award. So to be realistic, it's like, how do you get into the final without playing in the semi-final? So we really didn't expect to win, even though people were saying the town was looking very well, it was different, and you know, some people fancied us to win. But I had to be realistic. And to be honest, when I could not believe, you know, it was most exciting to be there to watch all the other towns being eliminated and you still there in the last four to be Ireland's tidiest town. That was very exciting. But when the minister said that we won the large urban area, really and truly, oh, never forget it. Wonderful.
Jim's aspiration for Tidytowns is to claim the title of Ireland's tidiest town. So in order to make this dream a reality, Letterkenny must improve by three vital points.
When you take part in the National Tidytown competition, we're judged in 10 different sections. Now, Letterkenny has worked very hard at those 10 sections over the years. Now, if you look at today's result, the adjudicator actually tells you that we're 3 points behind Ockham, just 3 points out of 400. But the adjudicator will actually point out to you what the way forward is. And our way forward is tidiness. We must eliminate tidiness. We have a lot of untidiness about the town. The entry into the town, we have a beautiful pole star, and we have the dry arch roundabout. We have all the lovely roundabouts. But then we have a lot of illegal signs, tatty signs on the way into town. We allow too many signs for circuses. We allow, you know, they're causing, there's a lot of untidiness in the town. And we need the cooperation of everyone, the local council, we need the cooperation of the public. If we eliminate the untidiness that's in the town, then I don't think anything can stop us. We can win the overall title.
Jim McCormick is a remarkable man. His passions in life are family, business and Tidytowns, and he has certainly excelled in all of these areas. Deputy Jim McDade calls him Detailed Jim, which sums up the meticulous nature of everything that he does. Nothing is left to chance. While his own business mantra is, the day you buy is the day you sell, and this sums up the importance he places on purchasing power, it is also the reason why McGee's has the reputation it has for great value. So with over 40 years of business under his belt, a National Tidytowns title, and a dedicated family network, there is no doubt that the legacy of Jim McCormick will forever live on in Letterkenny, but we can also be sure that it doesn't stop here.